Hello students, welcome to online classes of Sunstar Global School. I am Ramesh Sharma. Today I am going to start chapter 5, division. So what is division? The separation of something into different part is called division. Or we can say that the sharing of something into different people is called division. Okay? In maths language we can say when we divide a number by another number is called division. Okay? See the example.
487 divided by 5.
This is division sign. Okay?
Now, this is called dividend and this is divisor.
The number by which we divide is called divisor and the number which is divided is called dividend. Clear? A number by which divide another number is called divisor and the number which is divided is called dividend. Okay?
Now, see, 487 divided by 5.
Now, see, there is in one digit in divisor. So, first of all, we will take first digit. It means that is 4. But 4 is less than 5. In this case,
now we can take 2 digit.
Okay, now it becomes 48. Okay, so 5, 5 ones are 5, 5 twos are 10, 5 threes are and so on, 5 nines are 45.
So right here, 45.
Because 5 tens are 50, but 48 is less than 50, that is why we will take 5 nines are
45. Now subtract. 8 minus 5 is 3. 4 minus 4 is 0.
You can use a cross also. Okay.
Now take this number. It becomes 7. 3 becomes 37.
Again divide this 37 by 5. 5 ones are 5. 5 to the 10. 5 sevens are 35.
Now again 5 at the 40,
but we can't take 40 because 37 is less than 40. So take 5 sevens are 35.
7 minus 5 is 2 and then 3 minus 3 is 0.
See,
this 2 is remainder. And this 97 is quotient. Okay? Quotient. And you know that it is divisor and it is dividend.
Clear?
So again,
487 which is divided by 5, it is called dividend. By which divide, it means 5, it is divisor. Whatever we get in the result, it is remainder and it is quotient. Clear?
Now, see another example of division. This one is A, now B. Divide 471 by 3.
Okay, so you know that 471 is dividend, 3 is divisor.
Quotient is find quotient and remainder.
What is quotient? What is remainder?
So 471. 3 ones are 3.
I told you now. First we will take the ones digit. Because there is only one digit. That is I will take one digit from dividend. In this case 4 is greater than 3. That is I will take one digit only. But here you can see 4 is less than 5. That's I will take 2 digit. 48.
So 3 ones are 3, now 1 and 7.
Okay?
3 fives are 15. Now we have 2. It becomes 27 after taking this one digit. Now 3 sevens are 21. Clear? See, you can use here 0 and cross also. Both are same. Now, you can see there is no remainder. So, quotient is 157 and remainder is 0. See, quotient is 157 and remainder is 0. Clear? Now, next question is divide and check your answer. See the example, 782 divided by 6. Okay? So, first of all, I'm going to divide this number by 6. 6 ones are 6. Now subtract 7 minus 6 is 1. Now take this 8 now. 18. 6 threes are 18. Now cross and the last digit is 2. See, this 2 is not remainder. Now because this 2 is the part of 782. That is why we will divide this 2 by 6 again. But you know that 6 ones are 6. And 6 greater than 2. That is why we will take 6 zeros are 0. Now this 2 becomes the remainder of this question. Okay. So now check your answer. So first of all I am going to write dividend is given 782. Divisor is how much? 6. Now quotient is 130 and the last remainder is 2. And you know that the formula of dividend is equals to quotient multiply by divisor plus remainder. You know that dividend equals to quotient multiply by divisor plus remainder. Now put the value of dividend is 782, quotient is 130, divisor 6 plus remainder 2. Okay. Now multiply these two numbers. 130 multiplied by 6. Yesterday we have done this now. 13 6 are 78. Now put the 0 also. 780 now. See, 13 6 are 78 and then there is 1 0 only, so put here 1 0, 780 plus 2 and in the left hand side again 782. So, sum of 780 and 2 is 782 and in the LHS is also 782. In this case, you can see 782 equals to 782, it means left hand side is equals to right hand side. Hence, prove that our answer is correct. Clear? In this way, you can verify your answer by this formula. Dividend equals to quotient multiplied by divisor plus remainder. After that, put the values of each and every term like dividend, quotient, divisor and remainder. Then after multiply and sum, you can get the result. That is, your answer is correct or not. Clear? Fill in the blanks now. See the first A, 59 divided by 1. When we divide a number by 1, then we will get the same number. It means 59. This is the one of the property of division also. Okay. It means if we divide a number by 1, then we will get the same number. It means like 1 lakh divided by 1 is 1 lakh. 243 divided by 1. 243, 3 crore divided by 1, 3 crore. Okay. Now B, 2483 divided by 2483.
If we divide a number by itself, then we will get 1.
This is also one of the property of
division. In this case, if we divide a number, any number, by itself, then we'll get answer as quotient 1. Okay, like 3000 divided by 3000, 1. 4 lakh divided by 4 lakh, 1. Okay, and so on. Now see, 0 divided by 183. If we divide 0 by a number, any number, then we will get
0 as answer or quotient.
Okay.
Now B, the dash is always smaller than the divisor. So the answer is the remainder is always smaller than the divisor. See, if you divide a number like 8 divided by 3, 3 2s are 6, 2 as remainder, and 2 is less than divisor. Okay, now another example, suppose 4 and 87. 4 2s are 8. Now take this 7. 4 1s are 4. 3 as remainder. Again, this 3 is less than 4. In this way, we can say that the remainder is always smaller than the divisor. Clear? Now, next. If the divisor is 1, the quotient is equal to the dash. See, divisor is 1. See the first question, 59 divided by 1. Is the divisor is 1. The quotient is equals to the, this quotient is equals to the dividend. So right here, dividend. See, if the divisor is 1, the quotient is equals to the dividend. When divide number by 1, then we'll get the same number as quotient. It means dividend equals to quotient. Okay. Next question. Find the quotient and remainder. First question is 58,236 divided by 28. So divide this number. But you don't know the table of 28. So we will multiply and then write. See, 28 multiplied by 2. 8 plus 16, 2 to the 4 plus 1, 5. See, 28 ones are 28, 28 twos are 56. And 56, so write here 28 twos are 56. Subtract 8 minus 6 is 2. Now cross. So take this one number also, 22. So 22 is less than 28. So we'll take this 3 also. But before taking this 3, we'll put here 1, 0. Okay, then we can take 2 digits from this dividend. See, according to the rule of division, we can take 1 digit only. Okay, see, like this, only 1 digit, 2. But if you want to take this carry, it means this number is not enough for this divisor. In that case, you can put 1, 0, then you can take 2 digits. Clear? Now it becomes 223. Okay, so multiply this number 28, 5s are 140. Now again, I think is 2 less than 223. So 28, 9s are 972, carry 7. 9 2s are 18 plus 7, 25. 252 is greater than 223. So now we'll take 28 8s are 8 8s are 64, carry 6. Now 8 to 16 plus 6, 22. See, 28 8s are 224. Again, 224 is one more than 223. That's why we will have to take 28 sevens are. 8 sevens are 56, carry 5. 7 twos are 14 plus 5, 19. Clear? 8 times 56, 6, carry 5, 7 to the 14 plus 5, 19. So write here 196. Now subtract. 30 minus 6 is 7, and 11 minus 9 is 2. 27. Take this number also, 6. Now, you know that 28 nines are 252. See this. 28 nines are 252 and 28 tens are 280. See, 28 tens are. It is 280 now. According to the rule of multiplication, 28 ones are 28 and then put 10. 280. So, this number is lie between 28 nines and 28 tens are. Because 252 and 280. We can't take 280 because 280 is greater than 276. That is why we will take nines are. 28, first of all write this 7, then 28 nines are 252. Now subtract, 6 minus 2 is 4, 7 plus 5 is 2. So, see, 2079 is quotient. And remainder is 24. Clear? After dividing this number by 28, we will get the quotient as 2079 and remainder as 24. Clear?